गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, माई सेल्फ विनोद भाली, कंटिन्यूइंग अवर चैप्टर 3, सिंथेटिक फाइबर्स एंड प्लास्टिक। इन अवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव स्टडी अबाउट द सिंथेटिक फाइबर्स। नाउ टुडे वी विल स्टडी द अबाउट द प्लास्टिक्स। नाउ एज द सिंथेटिक फाइबर आर द पॉलीमर्स, सिमिलरली टू दैट द प्लास्टिक आर ऑल्सो द पॉलीमर्स। दे आर पॉलीमर्स ऑफ द कार्बन, इन विच कार्बन आर अरेंज्ड इन अ लीनियर वे, और इट कैन अरेंज इन द वर्टिकल और हॉरिजॉन्टल वे ऑल्सो। यू कैन सी इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक ऑल्सो द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ कार्बन एटम्स इज गिवन। द कार्बन एटम कैन बी अरेंज इन द हॉरिजॉन्टल वे एंड द कार्बन एटम्स कैन ऑल्सो अटैच विथ ईच अदर टू फॉर्म अ लॉन्ग चेन। वर्टिकली ऑल्सो in this way the carbon atoms can attach with each other in linear way and the horizontal and vertical ways. So that is the chain of the plastics we can represent. The box here are representing the carbon atoms. Now there are two types of plastics are there, the first thermoplastic and the second thermosetting plastic. Those plastics which can be molded, remolded into different shapes and sizes on heating are known as thermoplastic. For example, polyethylene, PVC, thermopol, etc. These are the examples of the thermoplastic. As we heat them, they can melt down and they can be remolded into a different shapes are known as thermoplastic. Whereas those plastic which cannot be molded on heating, means once they are made, they cannot be reshaped again. That type of plastics are known as thermosetting plastic. For example, bakelite and melamine. So, those plastics that can be remolded on heating are called thermoplastic. For example, polyethylene, PVC, etc. So, what is the definition of thermoplastic? The plastic can be remolded on heating are called thermoplastic. Example, polyethylene PVC. Next, the another one, those plastic that cannot be remolded on heating are called thermosetting plastic. For example, bakelite, melamine, etc. Yes. Now here the bakelite are bad conductor of heat and electricity, so they are used for making the electric switches, that telephone handles, etc. That is made up of bakelite. And melamine is the bad conductor of heat, so the tiles, kitchen wares, etc. are being made by the melamine, and the fabrics which does not catch the fire are made by this melamine, since it is a versatile material and cannot affected by the fire and heat. Now the plastic and the environment. As we know that the plastic is a non-reactive substance, it does not react with the gases and the moisture present in the environment, and so does not corrode easily, so they are used for storing the food material and many other food edible items in a container. So the containers are made by the plastic. Next, the plastic are lightweight, strong and durable. So the plastic items are made for in our day-to-day life. There are so many plastic items are used that are made up of the plastic, since they are lightweighted, durable and strong, and they are cheaper in cost. Next, poor conductor of electricity and heat. Since the plastic is a poor conductor of electricity, so it is used for wrapping or covering the wires, and it is poor conductor of heat, so the handles of the cooking utensils are made up of these plastics, since they are bad conductor of heat. Next, there are two types of substances: biodegradable substances and non-biodegradable substances. Those substances which cannot be degraded or decomposed by the action of microorganisms are known as non-biodegradable substances. For example, plastic are non-biodegradable substances. Those substances that cannot be decomposed by the action of microorganisms are called non-biodegradable substances. For example, plastic, polythene, etc. Since the plastic is a non-biodegradable substance, so it is responsible for the pollution of the environment, as we cannot biodegrade the plastic, but we can burn the plastic. As we burn the plastic, the poisonous fumes comes out from the plastic on burning, and due to that air pollution causes. So it is not environment friendly. Next, the biodegradable substances. Those substances that can be decomposed by the action of microorganisms are called biodegradable substances. For example, clothes, vegetable peels, fruits, straw, grasses, cotton fiber, etc. So these are the biodegradable substances. Now, to prevent our environment or to conserve our environment, we need to follow the 5 R's. These 5 R's are: reduce, reuse, recycle, recover and refuse. These are the 5 R's we should follow to conserve our environment. First of all, the reduce. we should reduce our needs so that those substances which are needed should be used, because we are so many of the people takes the unnecessary items which are of no use. So we should reduce our needs so that there should be less wastage and the environment pollution should be reduced. Next, the reuse. We can use the substances more than one times, and that is known as reuse. For example, we can use some of the substances or the utensils, polythene bags, etc., more than one times for storing of the substances which are solid or raw. So by using them more than one time, it is reuse of the substances. Then recycle. Some of the substances we can recycle them, means we can convert these substances into a different other items and it can be used again. That is known as recycling of the substances. Recover. We can use the substances instead of the plastic or the other items. That is known as recovering of the items. For example, the poly bags can be replaced by the cotton bags and other, or the paper bags we can use instead of the plastic bags, polythene bags, etc. Next, the refuse. We should refuse the substances which pollute the environment, and so we can help other people and us also to conserve the environment. I hope you are able to understand. Thank you. Have a nice day. Stay home. Stay safe.